Saite Academy New Delhi Amadi Saite Seba Samiti Kaxing Manipur Anina Kupsan Aduna Saliba Thasigi Jungitang Nipan Amadi Mapal Soklising Nitaraga Nipalda All India Jang Writers Meet Kaxing Gardelda Numinini Subna Pangthoki All India Jang Writers Meet Asigi Aruiba Numitki Anisuba Sessionda DB Priyana Chair Logduna Tongan Tongan Balon Singda Sering Pathoknaki
Very wonderful place like this. Before coming here, I never knew that there exists a place like this. We always thought that Kerala is the ultimate in natural beauty, and we call it God's own country and all that. I think more than one country. So Manipur is certainly one of it. Thank you for this. Manipuris are a great race. Manipuris are a great race, a great warriors, great performance of art, some of the most beautiful faces, both men and women. Most beautiful faces I have ever seen, glowing with divinity, pulsating with an infinite energy. Such awesome nature dancing all around. My young Manipuri friends, my young friends belonging to the Seven Sisters, I call upon you to continue to write about your land, your ignored and neglected rights. Write about your shrouded identity. Unveil your struggle. Unleash your creativity. Make your presence felt, not just in the hills of the north, not just in the hills of the northeast, but also on national platforms.
Ahan bada. डोगरी लोंदा रीता कुमार शर्मा
कविता का विषय है कल कल वह जो आएगा नहीं कल वह जो आएगा नहीं मिलेगा नहीं पहचाना भी नहीं मिलेगा नहीं पहचाना भी नहीं जिसके बारे में मालूम कुछ भी नहीं जिसके बारे में मालूम कुछ भी नहीं ना मिला सदियों से ना मिल रहा है ना कभी मिलेगा शायद पर जिसको पाने के लिए बर्बाद करते हैं हम अपना आज अब मैं आपको एक डोगरी में लिखी हुई कविता सुनाता हूँ जिसका शीर्षक है मतलब रात सोनी दिंदी मिगी रात हर रोज उंदी याद बद्दा लालच मठोदियां ख्वाहिशां त्रुटदियां मेदां बेईमानी दी सट कटदा सच समदा इरख
अनिश बदा मणिपुरी लोंदा थिंगनाम परशुराम
आई गे चेगे लहोंग बा नरांग अहिं दगी थी बखंगलक प्रभा आई गे चे नशी नोंगालक पा अमम अंगान सिनरक पददी पाव तारे आई गे चेदो लहोंग खरे रुपा मयुंदा चट खरे ऐगि चेगे फिशा कोंदा यचिन दुना तारम्मे मकुन फारबे चेगे सम्ब्रै कोक्त्रिबे शमलांग ngarang nung thil i chedo chenghi shambal lang khibane basanta da le na gani khanduna i chege wahong na kalakwa yam na basham palem pantho lekai maru mapang loina kappe ऊब फंगलरोब मीग्रबी अमत लेजी इचेदन लुहब इचेना अयुद लाजब लेरान तखेल नाचोम सुमांगी लेरान मको कायन तारम्मे मदुबु मोलांखादा थम्जुदुना इचेना बसंतबु खौरांग नंगाइजबने अहिंग खुदिंग नुमित खुदिंग मंगलांदा तावदुना अइगि चेगि शमगि मनम हेंगलि नाचो मदुदा खंगदे अइगि चेना असु तमथिना लुहोंख्रिबसे करिगिनो अइगि चेगि लैमचुगि इनफिना कोंथोंगि कोरोंदा फनेकना चिंगगि चिंखोंद अइगि चेदो तसेंगम लुहोंख्रबने नरांग अहिंग सिटकिबा हु पुब नोंले नुशिप अदुदा मफी अमत पक्तना पिजोल अमत थोंगदना थक थक निकना खा चिपना
And here it goes, the English translation of the read poem, My Sister's Wedding. My sister missing since last night. Early today, when darkness fades out in the first light, we hear my sister has got married and gone to her groom, there not to be seen again. Caught on her loom, my sister's log lies still smelling of sangbrae. Last afternoon, my sister bathed her hair in Jianghe, hoping to show it off to spring, her thick hair that peacocks envy. Mother, father, and friends from the neighborhood, they all mourn her getting married. My only sister, not of ours, and never to be seen again. The takelei buns my sister makes every morning is found lying broken at the end of the court. Keeping that under her pillow, she thought of spring in love every night and every day in reverie. The smell of her hair still lingers on the buns. We know not why my sister got married so brutally. Her pink shawl is found caught on the bamboo gate, her shirt on the village outskirt. Her fennec at the foot of the hill. My sister has actually got married to poison storm that swept last night with nothing on, trembling and biting her lips. And here is another poem, Postman. Unaware whether anybody is home or not, in front of a big house, even without getting up on the porch, is anybody home? Hello, anybody home? Postman, the postman, hello, the postman. Oh, postman, coming every day and calling here. Aren't you yet tired with the bag on your back? So big. How many letters will you leave dear yet again today? Oh, so many letters pile up in heaps in the porch. As soon as the sun set, you would toss the letters in the ports and run away and return at daybreak and stand in the yard again with another big bag of letters slung over your shoulder. Is anybody home? Hello, anybody home? Postman, the postman, hello, the postman. Oh, postman, if you push the door of the big house guarded by ghosts, would a cloud of bats spurt out, walking in, clearing cobweb in the dark, would you stumble on and fall among skeletons that you cannot identify, though they may be of those carrying letters of edges and edges who tear up the ports.
Let me end off my reading after reading the translation of the shed. Poem Postman. The Manipuri translation is here. Chithi puba. Mi lai haibasu khangdaba, laite haibasu khangdaba, chawraba yum amagi sumangda, mangol phawba kakhatdana, yum shibukana laibage imung shibukana laibage chithi puba lakliye chithi puba lakliye nungpi gi laurani ba ho chithi puba wadribara nangbu chokthadribara nanam do pori ba chithi gi khaw lo onthok na chawri ba chithi kaya no nahak na yum sida thamlam gadaba ngashina oh yam laba chithi singna mangol asida mapai mapai pairiba numitna tarak labadi nai khoi chithi singado mangol da langsilam laga hauduna hekta chenki nonga laga muklai sumang asida muklep lei nanam da poraduna chaur ba chithi gi khau amagamo yum sibukana laibage imung sibukana laibage chithi pubalak liye chithi pubalak liye ho chithi puba bhut pret thadok tuna ngak libra yam la chaur ba yum jaw se thong induna manung da changlurabadi shekpi charong charong paithorakadara amam bada mirang haidok tuna changbada kangje naduna tu gadara saru sarang marakta amana kanagino amana karigino haiba khangdrabasu oiram gadara saru polang singado mangol ka bangam khiba haktak haktak ki chithi pubasingge thank you
I don't understand manipuri Obviously, you have read a very good poem, it seems, by the response you are getting from the audience here. Thank you for that. And now I request Mr. Kalyan Saurav Das.
Ahum Subhada Uriya Londa Kalyan Saurav Das.
Samudra. Samudra Gita Gaye, Suni Chake Be Manasi. Samudra Gita Gaye, Suni Chake Be Manasi. ତୁମକୁ ତ ବେଶୀ ପସନ୍ଦ ବେଳାଭୂମିର କୋଳାହଳ ତୁମକୁ ତ ବେଶୀ ପସନ୍ଦ ବେଳାଭୂମିର କୋଳାହଳ ଶଙ୍ଖ ଦୋକାନୀ ଶଙ୍ଖା ବେପାରୀ ଝାଲମୁଢ଼ି ଓଟ ସବାରୀ କୂଳର ଲହଡ଼ି ଓ ଲହଡ଼ି ସହ ଛକାପଞ୍ଝା ଖେଳୁଥିବା ଅଗଣିତ ଭିଡ଼ କେବେ ଭିଡ଼ କମିଲେ କାନ ଡେରିବ ମାନସୀ କେବେ ଭିଡ଼ କମିଲେ କାନ ଡେରିବ ମାନସୀ ଅଧରାତିରେ ସମୁଦ୍ର କାନ୍ଦେ ବି ଭୋ ଭୋ କରି ଅଧରାତିରେ ସମୁଦ୍ର କାନ୍ଦେ ବି ଭୋ ଭୋ କରି ଯେବେ ତା ଛାତିରେ ସୁନାମି ଆସେ ନୋଳିଆ ବସ୍ତିର ଛତରା ଟକାଟା କଥା ନ ମାନି ମଝି ପାଣିରେ ଗଞ୍ଜେଇ ଟାଣି ଟ୍ରାଞ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟର ବନ୍ଦ କରି ବେଧଡ଼କ ଶୋଇପଡ଼ିଥାଏ ଆଉ ଓଲଟି ପଡ଼େ ଡଙ୍ଗା ଯେବେ ତା ଛାତିରେ ସୁନାମି ଆସେ ନୋଳିଆ ବସ୍ତିର ଛତରା ଟକାଟା କଥା ନ ମାନି ମଝି ପାଣିରେ ଗଞ୍ଜେଇ ଟାଣି ଟ୍ରାଞ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟର ବନ୍ଦ କରି ବେଧଡ଼କ ଶୋଇପଡ଼ିଥାଏ ଆଉ ଓଲଟି ପଡ଼େ ଡଙ୍ଗା Now I will read an English translation of a poem. The original Odia is titled Chalo Jeeba. I have tried to translate it somehow. I don't know if I could say the same thing which I could have said in Odia. Please bear with me. The English title is Let Us Leave. See those beautiful bunch of cranes sitting on the treetop ready to fly. See those beautiful bunch of cranes sitting on the treetop ready to fly. Let us show them our hands and ask for white flowers on our fingertips. Let us visit the back of our notebooks and once again bet in the game of tic-tac-toe. Let us take out the big-headed weapons from inside in the bud of Golmohar and fight. That peacock plumage we had brought up, feeding it parched rice hiding between pages. That peacock plumage we had brought up, feeding it parched rice hiding between pages, let us see how much it has grown since. The moss-clad heap of bricks staring at the half-built wall, uncared, unattended as the old age. Let us cover it with dried palm leaves and enjoy some carambola when no one is watching. Let us advise those piled-up bricks, if at all it comes to mind while returning, The old loner, Mr. Pani, has long gone, emerged in soil, and now they should follow him one after another, become soil, for death is birth only. Then we shall build a spire from that soil, that red newborn soil, and we break it again. Let us dream.
Marisubada Santali Londa Ganesh Marandi.
My poem in mother tongue Santali. The title is Danang. নানাহুনার রং রেন ᱢᱟᱹᱱᱢᱤ ᱛᱟᱞᱟᱨᱮ ᱠᱚᱭᱚᱜ ᱛᱷᱤᱨ ᱢᱤᱱᱟᱹᱧᱟ ᱤᱧ ᱫᱚ ᱟᱛᱮᱱ ᱟᱠᱟᱫᱟᱹᱧ ᱥᱟᱦᱮᱸ ᱟᱨ ᱜᱮᱨᱟᱝ ᱛᱟᱠᱚ ᱢᱮ ᱢᱩᱴᱷᱟᱹᱱ ᱦᱟᱛᱲᱟᱹᱣ ᱦᱟᱛᱲᱟᱹᱣ ᱞᱟᱦᱟ ᱪᱟᱞᱟᱜ ᱠᱟᱱᱟᱹᱧ ᱞᱟᱦᱟ ᱪᱟᱞᱟᱜ ᱠᱟᱱᱟ ᱡᱩᱫᱤ ᱦᱟᱹᱨᱭᱟᱹᱲ ᱢᱟᱹᱱᱢᱤ ᱤᱧ ᱧᱟᱢ ᱠᱚ ᱮᱥᱠᱟᱨ ᱱᱤᱪᱳᱞ ᱵᱮᱲᱟᱨᱮ ᱢᱤᱫᱴᱟᱝ ᱪᱮᱬᱮ ᱟᱨ ᱨᱟᱜ ᱟᱨ ᱢᱤᱫᱴᱟᱝ ᱩᱞ ᱥᱟᱠᱟᱢᱟᱜ ᱜᱟᱞᱚᱪ ᱟᱸᱡᱚᱢ ᱦᱤᱡᱩᱜᱼᱟ ᱜᱟᱹᱦᱤᱨ ᱫᱚᱨᱭᱟ ᱯᱟᱨᱚᱢ ᱠᱟᱛᱮ ᱦᱤᱱᱫᱤ ᱴᱨᱟᱱᱥᱞᱮᱥᱚᱱ ᱥᱤᱨᱥᱚᱠ ᱦᱮ ᱪᱤᱠ ᱵᱤᱠᱨᱮ ᱦᱮ ᱞᱟᱹᱦᱩ ᱨᱟᱥᱛᱮ ᱠᱮ ᱪᱟᱨᱚ ᱚᱨ ᱡᱷᱟᱨᱢᱩᱴ ᱠᱮ ᱯᱟᱛᱛᱮ ᱯᱟᱨ ᱡᱟᱢᱮ ᱯᱟᱲᱦᱮ ᱛᱷᱟᱠᱮ ᱛᱷᱟᱠᱮ ᱩᱱᱥᱮ ᱜᱤᱨᱛᱮ ᱴᱚᱯ ᱴᱚᱯ ᱵᱟᱹᱦᱤ ᱞᱟᱹᱦᱩ ᱪᱟᱨᱚ ᱚᱨ ᱫᱮᱠᱷ ᱠᱟᱨ ᱯᱷᱚᱞᱚᱠ ᱡᱷᱟᱯᱟᱠᱛᱮ ᱱᱟᱹᱦᱤ ᱚ ᱢᱟᱨᱢᱤᱠ ᱫᱨᱤᱥᱥᱚ ᱚᱡᱷᱚᱞ ᱦᱚᱛᱤ ᱦᱤ ᱱᱟᱹᱦᱤ ᱠᱷᱩᱱ ᱥᱮ ᱞᱚᱛᱯᱷᱚᱛ ᱚ ᱢᱟᱥᱩᱢ ᱪᱮᱦᱨᱟ ᱦᱟᱸ ᱥᱟᱹᱦᱤ ᱢᱮ ᱵᱚᱭᱱᱚ ᱠᱟᱛᱷᱟ ᱢᱮᱨᱟ ᱫᱷᱟᱹᱨᱛᱤ ᱟᱸᱫᱮ ᱢᱩᱦᱮ ᱯᱟᱲᱟ ᱦᱮ ᱞᱟᱞ ᱪᱷᱚᱛ ᱠᱮ ᱛᱟᱞᱮ ᱪᱷᱩᱯᱩ ᱛᱚ ᱢᱮ ᱠᱟᱦᱟᱸ ᱪᱷᱩᱯᱩ ᱪᱤᱠᱚ ᱠᱮ ᱵᱤᱪᱚ ᱵᱤᱪ ᱟᱵ ᱠᱟᱦᱟᱸ ᱨᱟᱠᱷᱩ ᱯᱷᱟᱲᱠᱛᱮ ᱢᱮᱨᱟ ᱵᱩᱲᱮ ᱠᱟᱞᱮ ᱪᱟᱠᱩ ᱫᱮᱱ ᱮᱱᱟᱫᱟᱨ ᱦᱤᱱᱫᱤ ᱴᱨᱟᱱᱥᱞᱮᱥᱚᱱ ᱡᱩᱱ ᱥᱟᱱᱛᱟᱲ ᱦᱩᱞ ᱠᱟ ᱢᱟᱦᱤᱱᱟ 1855 ᱥᱟᱞ ᱥᱤᱯᱟᱹᱦᱤ ᱵᱤᱫᱽᱫᱨᱳᱦ ᱥᱮ ᱵᱤ ᱯᱩᱨᱵᱚ ᱡᱟᱜ ᱩᱴᱷᱟᱛᱟ ᱫᱟᱢᱮᱱᱤᱠᱚ ᱡᱚᱵ ᱠᱷᱩᱱ ᱥᱮ ᱥᱟᱱᱮ ᱯᱤᱴ ᱫᱤᱣᱟᱞ ᱯᱚᱨ ᱴᱤᱠᱟ ᱛᱷᱟ ᱯᱤᱴ ᱯᱚᱨ ᱪᱟᱵᱩᱠ ᱠᱤ ᱪᱷᱟᱯ ᱥᱮ ᱟᱜ ᱠᱚ ᱯᱨᱚᱡᱚᱞᱤᱛ ᱠᱮᱭᱟ ᱥᱤᱫᱩ ᱠᱟᱱᱩᱱᱮ ᱡᱤᱵᱚᱱ ᱠᱚ ᱦᱟᱛᱟᱞᱤ ᱯᱚᱨ ᱨᱚᱠ ᱠᱟᱨ ᱟᱱᱫᱳᱞᱚᱱ ᱠᱤ ᱟᱜ ᱡᱟᱜᱟᱭ ᱯᱮᱲ ᱯᱚᱫᱚ ᱯᱚᱨ ᱵᱤ ᱛᱤᱨ ᱠᱮ ᱱᱚᱠ ᱥᱮ ᱠᱷᱤᱪ ᱥᱟᱱᱛᱟᱞ ᱦᱩᱞ ᱠᱤ ᱞᱟᱠᱤᱨ ᱠᱷᱩᱱ ᱥᱮ ᱞᱚᱛᱯᱚᱛ ᱪᱮᱦᱨᱮ ᱯᱚᱨ ᱵᱤ ᱪᱚᱢᱚᱠ ᱩᱴᱷᱟᱛᱟ ᱡᱩᱱ ᱵᱤᱫᱽᱨᱟᱹ ᱠᱟ ᱢᱟᱦᱤᱱᱟ
ᱢᱟᱝᱜᱟ ᱥᱩᱵᱟᱫᱟ ᱛᱟᱢᱤᱞ ᱞᱚᱱᱫᱟ ᱩᱢᱟᱭ ᱡᱟᱵᱚᱱ
ᱛᱷᱮᱝᱠ ᱤᱭᱩ ᱥᱟᱨ ᱥᱮᱱᱫᱮᱢᱮᱲᱮ ᱩᱭᱨᱮ ᱱᱚᱨುᱱ್ದೇಣೆ செயலனை மூச்சினை உனக்கு அளித்தேனே நைந்தா என்னில் நைந்து போகும் என் வாழ்வின் நன்னிலை உனக்கெனில் எனக்கும் தானே வெரி வார்ம் குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் ஒன் அண்ட் ஆல் பிரசன்ட் ஹியர் ஐ எம் ஸ்டார்டிங் வித் த நேம் ஆஃப் மை மதர் டங் தமிழ் அண்ட் மகாகவி சுப்பிரமணிய பாரதி அண்ட் மை ஃபஸ்ட் ஐம் கோயிங் டு ப்ரெசன்ட் மை ஃபஸ்ட் போயம் தட்ஸ் ஆல் அபவுட் த ஃபார்மர்ஸ் அண்ட் தயர் கல்டிவேஷன் பியூட்டி ஆஃப் கல்டிவேஷன் த டைட்டில் இஸ் உழுத புழுதி ஏர் உழும் அப்பாவின் பின்னால் எத்தனை பறவைகள் காக்கை கறிக்குருவி நீண்ட கால் கொக்கு என எல்லாம் அணிவகுக்கும் கலப்பை உழுது புறந்தள்ளும் புழுக்களை கொத்த அவைகள் போட்டி போடும் காளைகளைச் சுற்றி தட்டான்கள் தனி கூட்டம் நடத்தும் தூர தேசத்தில் இருக்கும் தன் குஞ்சுகளுக்கும் இங்கிருந்தே இறை கொண்டு செல்லும் ஓர் தாய்ப்பறவை காளைகளை விரட்ட அப்பா உயர்த்தும் சாட்டையில் ஒரு நொடி உயரப் பறந்து அமரும் அப்பறவைகள் எங்கு ஆழ உழ வேண்டும் எங்கு மேலாக உழ வேண்டும் எல்லாம் அப்பாவுக்கு அத்துப்படி ஈரம் கூடவோ குறையவோ விடாமல் மண்பதம் பார்த்து உழவு சமைப்பார் அப்பா நிலம் தன் இறுக்கத்தை விளக்கியும் வேர்கள் சென்ற அடர்த்தியை தளர்த்தியும் நிர்வாணமாக படர்ந்து கிடக்கும் காளைகளின் கால்தடங்களை சுமந்து வரலாறாகிறது மண் காற்றில் பறக்கும் புழுதியில் மண் பறக்கிறது உழுத பொழுதியில் நிலத்தின் பூரிப்பு மிளிரும்
ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு ப்ரெசன்ட் மை நெக்ஸ்ட் போயட்ரி தட்ஸ் இன் இங்கிலீஷ் ட்ரான்ஸ்லேட் பை மிஸ்டர் அமரன் ப்ளவிங் ஆஸ் ஏ ரைட்டிங் ஒன்லி ஆன் எர்த்தன் சாயில் இட்ஸ் ப்ளூம் த ப்ரைம் லெட்டர் இட்ஸ் ஆன் த ரெட் சாயில் த ஃபஸ்ட் லெட்டர் அரோஸ் ஏ those straight lines. Strange enough it was that all I wrote saw printing. The first collection of volume itself must be a collective effort of farmer and bullock. Only here it generated, I suppose, they saying that all letters are seeds. I suppose to saying that all letters are seeds. To write is a kind of silence. To write is a kind of silence. A way of meditation, is it so? Nay, it cannot be so if you happen to watch a ploughing. Yes, if you're a poet. Yes, for a poet, alphabets are available in plenty for a farmer too. If so, how to earn income? It is for profit earn. Look here, comrades, either writing or ploughing.
Reading your Tamil poems and then some translations. Tamil Nadu, Tamil is in, it's making headlines, it's hitting the newspapers and the television channels. A politically motivated poet or writer, or somebody not so motivated politically, not so aware of the bitter things happening around him, still has a world of his own. He creates his world of his own, tries to live in that, and expects us to share it through his writings. So these are the two very important worlds existing for a poet and our young poets. I don't say that you should not write about your personal experiences. I myself write a lot about my personal experiences. My recent book, which was about 6 to 7 months back, was very personal. Most of the poems were written about my departed wife, Gali Rangu. Gali Rangu is the color of air. Usually we don't know what is the color of the air. But I think a poet can see the color of air. So that is it's a small poem. The title of the poem is Khan. This is translated by one of my friends, young friends, Professor Vijay Koganti, who teaches English in Guntur. Khan. I will make the brook stand upright. I will make the brook upright and set a flame, the fire with water. I will make the elephant walk on its trunk and level the Everest like a chapati. I will do something more than anybody else. I will do something more than anybody else. I will paint the air. I will paint the air. That. So thank you so much for listening to me so patiently and listening to the all young poets here who are the future of tomorrow in poetry. I wish them all the best. I don't know how many of them have already published.